Okay, I'll just start over. The punishment of happiness, those later feelings of regret, obliviousness at the time towards seeing that your life was fine. So now your current circumstance seems inferior to the past. Those better days were wasted on the fool whose joy has been forgone. I think the secret lies within the balance of reaching for the stars and gratitude, feeling that this is enough, conversely never giving up on pursuing a life full of meaning. The punishment of desire to realize that you're a liar when you say this is enough, but desperation calls your bluff. Fantasies of the ideal unlikely ever become real. To see your passions unfulfilled, mediocrity distilled, to think the secret lies within the balance of reaching for the stars and keeping one foot on the ground, feeling that this is enough, conversely never giving up on pursuing a life full of meaning. Ambitions have been subdued. The punishment of compassion, self-defeating inaction. The punishment of aptitude, responsibilities accrued. The punishment of virtue, bound to only speak the truth. The punishment of desire to realize that you're a liar. The up on pursuing a life full of meaning, or at least one worth redeeming. For 24 hours you lived as someone else. Your questionable choices affecting only yourself. Seeing what it's like to live with robots and deluxe toilet paper, upper middle class luxuries like being suspended in skydiving chambers, to transcend your life of stark disappointments and picking up slack for a temporary fantasy of having a husband who will have your back through financial security, the safety net of joint checking accounts as you pursue your artistry. He supports you to achieve what you're truly about. So you let your guard down and acted somewhat rash, mainly concerning the feats you accomplished while on your back. Seduced by status and novel encounters, not to mention a stunning physique, the heat of the moment repelled better judgment of any cautionary technique. So now you're back to your life. practical obligations and promises kept when you weren't mystified by romantic delusions which left you bereft. So you've got to decide between penniless sitar players on whom you've relied, or on the other hand, the Maharaja's fantasy, which might just